Chang, one of the parts of the Chang is the massive enterprise computing equipment, and I have two rack servers and one switching unit, and yeah, I've been looking at 19-inch racks, and at least from this region perspective there, I would like to have like a 4U, minimum 4U, actually more than 4U unit. But they're very expensive in this region, getting them ordered and shipped. So what I've been thinking is that if I could maybe build a simple stacking rack. And if you've been following the channel, you know I've been investing in welding equipment of various kinds, so I was thinking I'd just take this kind of standard tubing and then figure out how to build a totally customized for server equipment rack with a minimum of like 4U places. And then I want to have a table on top of that, so it would fit my small workshop. You probably noticed that I actually don't have enough space, or tabletop space, so it's gonna do double duty. It will be handling the technology, and then it will also be holding stuff, and then it'll have a table. So let's get into it. So here goes one. And then I have a little bit of a fat lift, so I have to make 8x70 and 8x45. That's what I'd show the first cut. And the rest is the 4-inch, the ferrous. Understand that the accuracy of this type of tool in the course of metalwork is, yeah, it's not very bad. But I just can't give up just checking things. So, within the tolerances that I can live with. So anyway, I'll just go get to work and cut all the bits. Everything was going fine before I started filming what I was doing. The effect of the camera. You know, I start screwing up stuff. It's like comedy camera. So, I see with it, like making YouTube videos, so I have to show that I actually didn't have enough material, so I actually used pretty much for videos, but I got more. For the next phase, I have to bring out my big welding table. As you see, it's got very sturdy legs, and the surface is very flat. You have to have a flat surface if you're going to weld. So, with the jig, we can position parts. Correct position. And that's the shelf, or the bottom of one shelf. So that's going to be four of those. Just have a little bit of extra weight to try and hold it down, so I won't jump around too much. Just got to cut the wire. Remember to spray some anti-stick. Earth connection. Put it out of the way. Now we'll move it.
No, it was wide enough. Why didn't it fit there? No, it doesn't. Impressive hard. So, let's see. Lid on. See if that tacked it on.
That's not what I want it to do. I think this is too heavy to move.
I don't like better well in the corner. Obviously that was just garbage. Too high up. I'm going to put them a bit low. Turns out that eating welding after a long day at work is not something that's very good for them. I was actually thinking if I should even try this. Once the lights disappear, most. guarantee that's gonna stay together. the light's just disappearing too fast. Difficult to do things in Scandinavia. Evenings. We actually don't have natural light for that one. Oh, let's get this cleaned up. Let's see what it looks like. Cleaned off a bit. I really doubt anybody's gonna hire me as a welder, but at least they seem to be somewhat stuck in every dimension. My car tear it apart. I'm trying to. I don't seem to want to be torn apart. I mean, basically each of these shells needs to carry weight distributed of 22 kilograms. It's going to have two supports. It's going to be like 10 kilos, 10 kilos. So it's not really that much. Well, let's see if it fits on a server. Well, looks like a bit of crap, but it fits on the server and I think it'll do. So it's just to do. Three more of the same. Well, not. Oh, video time this evening. We're just losing the lights. I would like to, or I have to work outside because I haven't got an inside place to weld. And I could use artificial light, but it's actually easier to do than the real light. Plus, I'm really tired. It's been a long day. So that's two done, and I evolved on welding a little bit. So. That's like the best example of going from real crap to something a little bit better. But I mean, both of them I've tested to break them, and they're both gonna hold enough to support this shelf that I'm building. So. But anyway, I learned some tips from a welding guy on YouTube, and I'll try and remember to put his link in the video, because I thought he had some very good top five or whatever. So I've been following those instructions, and I think I'm doing maybe a bit better. So, don't need the jig anymore, so I'm going to disassemble that. If I notice a weld that needs to be made better, then I will just to add some more weld to it. Not perfect, but I say good enough accuracy. I mean, for a home project, home hobby project, where tolerances aren't that important. I'm happy with that. How they match at the ends doesn't really matter. Or actually none of this time. It's the
distance between.
It matters. It's this distance here. It is kind of critical, but it doesn't vary that much. And that looks okay. Maybe a half a millimeter. I would think. And that's handleable. Okay, I got the end first shelf balanced. In the end there, so I'm gonna try and weld it up. So that's the end. Trying to get out of it. All I want to. It's going to pull the whole thing off the table. So that seems to be. So I welded it on both sides, on both ends. And it seems to be. So that's just to get the other ones. So that's the shelves in place. There will be four slots, and the last one will work as a top of a shelf for this area, and then put the table on top. So now I need to put the other side up. So I've got the other time two side bits approximately centered, and then as usual when you're welding, then things move and aren't exactly the same, and sort of put a few extra clamps to compensate for the heat distortion. I haven't been making any videos of this because this is very unique to this specific build, so. But it's getting closer to being correct. We'll just continue adjusting it until it's kind of straight. I mean, it doesn't have to be 100% straight. I mean, as you can see, we have the slots already, and they're going to work. You ever have what crooked I put these on? But I mean, aesthetically speaking, it's nice to have a reasonable control over the aesthetical looks. So, it's the other side welded up. Some of the welds are good, some of the welds are very bad. But I'm losing natural light here. And a bit of a heart. Yeah, and here's a good use for multi-material waste blocks. You can use them to create gaps and supports and stuff in your building. So anyway, I just have to clean this up a bit, and that'll be the next phase. Yep, here it is now. Oh, I hope I'm not going to get copyright slammed for music in the background. It's the neighbors playing music for. Anyway, see, doesn't shake. This is pretty flat, and it's not shaky. And, doesn't seem like any of those are loose. And yeah.
put some feet on it. So
I thought the front side would have the feet like that, because we're going to be putting the heavy service in from the front, and then in the back it'll just be cross, so provide a little bit of anti-tip support.
So that's just to clean it up and check, and maybe possibly add some more weld. And I don't think it's going to go anywhere. So next it will be the table holders. So anyway, that's the idea. I'm going to put some holes. This will be screwed into the tabletop, and now I'm just going to weld them onto the side there, and that will spread the weight and give good support. It'll hold the table so it won't move anymore.
Yep,
just going to drill some holes.
This has no position with them. As long as it's a hole. Thank you. not pretty, but I think it'll work.
So that's the tabletop, and the idea is that if when the tabletop gets crappy enough, then I'll just unscrew it and put a new one on. So it's no big deal. I just need to move it in there.
Oh, now it's in place. Now it's just to put the equipment out and it'll be done, so I have to think.
So, that's done. As you see, I have a free slot. Also space to build. Well, this is going to be temporarily used as a shelf. And I have the table. And if you're interested how the servers are connected, then you can look at my server commissioning playlist. And if you want to follow the networking, I'm running a series. It might even be completed by the time this is done, to have a 10 gigabit backend. So we'll see. Anyway, if you thought this video was was interesting, consider pressing the like button. It would really encourage me to make more. And if you'd like to buy me some merch to pay for some of this material, you're welcome to buy me a cup of coffee. Merch is also available. And I'll see you in the next one.